Fast rising water on the Missouri is once again flowing into NP Dodge Park. Boat docks are swamped, rising water turning parking lots into lakes, and it could get far worse over the next few days. Good evening, I'm Christy Anderson.
And I'm Todd Andrews. For the second time this year, high water forces NP Dodge Park to shut down. That means no one can camp there and nobody can use the marina.
KETV News Watch 7's Ryan Luby has been watching the water, river rise and is live with a big story at 6.
Well, Christy, before we get to that, let's first tell you about another issue that was here on the river not too long ago. Let's go to some video if we could. Just about an hour ago, rescuers were called here on a report of two people floating down the river, hanging onto a log. Somehow they managed to scramble onto a boat before rescuers could reach them. They're fine, though, and the rescue was quickly called off. Of course, there are a lot of questions as to how that happened, but of course, the river can be a dangerous place. And back out here live, you can see what we're talking about here. The water is not expected to crest until midday Saturday, but already, again, you can see what we are talking about. The docks are flooded, the parking lots covered. By this time tomorrow, the water will be all the way back into the playing fields, and that is why at 8 o'clock tonight, the city will lock the gates here once again.
It has probably come up probably a good 3 feet since yesterday.
As Mark Santee and his son Tyler watch, the river visibly rises.
Yes, it is quite a bit up.
In just 2 hours Friday morning, the ramp on the boat dock went from this to this. The stairs leading to the landing disappeared. And as the river rose further, water started to flow into the North Ramp parking lot.
We might have to get a boat.
And with a projected crest on Saturday almost 3.5 feet higher, the city has no choice but to close the park for a second time.
It's going up 2 inches an hour. We'll be completely underwater, probably all the way back to the campgrounds.
Closing the park this time will be easier, though. The camping areas are still locked down from the last flood, as most of the electrical boxes remain saturated with water. FEMA is picking up the tab for the first cleanup, but the cost to the city for this one could be significant.
We're still putting together all the costs because basically we just got finished cleaning up this last week, so it's been a work in progress.
Now the city waits for the crest to come and go, and families that use the park do the best to cover their disappointment and try to enjoy the novelty of the situation.
No, I haven't seen it this high in quite some time. I've never seen any geese over here swimming in the playground, I can tell you that.
Now, the city has found places for events that had been set up here for this weekend. The rugby tournament on Saturday has been moved to Levi Carter Park, and two private parties in the pavilion have been moved to other open facilities here in the park, and there's no word on when this park will finally reopen. Reporting live at NP Dodge Park, I'm Ryan Luby, KETV News Watch 7.